Hello, this is Bern, and if you want to understand how you can show up as an insanely high value woman, on today's episode, I'm gonna share with you 6 simple steps to do just that. So stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com, a space where I share with ambitious and conscious, heart-centered, successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract the kind of quality man you want, stepping into the most alive and feminine version of you, no need for manipulation, gimmicks, or games. Now, I'm gonna share with you 6 simple steps, to show up as the most high-value woman you can be. Now, it's kind of deceiving because you, by definition, are a high-value woman. The difference between being perceived as high value and not being perceived as high value has to do with the way you show up. You could be, in theory, a high value woman, but nobody knows about it because you're not showing up that way in the world. Well, it doesn't do you or anyone any good. So the first step, in my mind, that you have to embody if you want to show up and express your high value womanhood is clarity of values. And you decide what those values are, but be conscious of them. What is it that you want to go for in this life? What's really important to you? What is your life about? What is your legacy for? What are you willing to live and die for? What's most important to you in a relationship? What's most important to you in a friendship? What's most important to you in a family? When you have clarity of values, then your radar for looking for something similar can be activated. When you're unclear as to what your values are, then finding that elusive someone is much, much harder. And showing up in a way where people can understand who you are is harder as well because you're not clearly defined as a human being. Number 2, expressiveness of being. Step number 2, if you want to not just be a high value woman in secret, but be show up in the world where people recognize and feel, and men especially recognize you as an insanely high value woman that they want to pursue and get to know and potentially marry and have children with and grow old with, is expressiveness of being. And the expressiveness of being has a range. That means from the funny and relaxed to intense and sensual. Being able to, that part inside of you that makes you who you are, express it more generously, more openly, more courageously, more passionately into the world, allows men around you to connect with you, see you, smell you from a distance and say, this is someone that I want to get to know. This is someone that I want to, I'm interested in her. There's something that hits me in the heart about her and gets that little thing going that makes it all happen. So expressiveness of being is step number 2. Step number 3 is commitment to the values that you choose to embody. Why? Because if step 1 is clarity of values, then the commitment to live by those values is very, very important. Why? Because, I mean, you need to know what you want first. But if you know what you want and you're not doing it or living it or stepping into it, then it's lack of integrity in some way. So once you're clear on what you want, being willing to live a life that is more difficult than not, because values that you choose are probably gonna be hard values to live up to. If you value integrity, if you value honesty, if you value courage, if you value love, if you value compassion, stepping into those values is gonna be significantly harder than stepping into whatever comes, whatever you feel like doing. Discipline, for example, is harder than just waking up and whatever you feel that day, but they create a different destination. So third step is commit to the values that you know are important for you. Number 4 is such a powerful thing because it makes you stand out from all the women in the world, because only you can be you. So it's a commitment to being you. And I'm not saying commitment to being you in any way, shape, or form. I'm saying commitment to being the best version of you. Commitment to being the you who is connected to something greater than yourself. The commitment to being the you who wants to service the world and wants to give more of yourself in service of something that's beyond your life. Commitment to your happiness, commitment to your greatness, commitment to your truth. The commitment to you being the unique flavor version, kind of like your thumbprint that's different and unique from any other human being. The commitment to going all in on who you really are at your best, that is something that, again, puts you in a different category, because most people are not doing that. So the more you are you at your best, the more you are not just being, but being perceived as a high value woman. Number 5, the willingness to ask for what you need. Now, let's say you have the clarity of the values that you want and you're stepping into them. But if you don't have the courage and the clarity and the directness to ask for what you want from a guy, from a partner, from a soulmate, then the likelihood that you'll get it is very low. There's this ideal that's romantic in nature and goes thousands of years back that says, well, if somebody knows you really well, they'll know what you want without you even asking it. You'll be thinking of it and then he'll say, were you thinking of this? And you'll say, yes, that's what I was thinking about. So it sounds romantic, but I think it's bullshit. Why is it bullshit? Not because people can't guess what you're thinking, but because the commitment to expressing your needs is going to be something that gets you much more of what you want with a lot less potential for failure. So have the courage to say, dude, man, guys who's pursuing me, here's what I need to thrive. Here's what I need to feel respected. Here's what I need to feel passionate. Here's what I need to feel security, safety, commitment, whatever it is that you need, be willing to express it. Sixth, and this will define high value women from no women who are not showing up as high value women, is your ability to walk away. Your ability to have a deep sense of faith in yourself and that there's something in line for you that is amazing if you're willing to go all in on yourself and ask for what you want and move away from shitty propositions that are not ideal for you in any way, shape, or form, or that are close to ideal, but you know there's something inside that's making it a showstopper. Your ability to say no and do what you have to do when you have to, at the risk of losing that relationship with that man, will set you apart and will make the guy know exactly where he stands and potentially and very likely allow him to act in ways that he wouldn't if he felt that he has you no matter what he does. Hope this is helpful, insightful, and useful to you in some way, and hope that you step into more of your amazing high-value self with men, in relationships, and with people around you. If this is helpful to you, I'm gonna ask you to do three things, my dear. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel, and if you want to be notified of new episodes, click the little bell and you'll get notifications. Third and most important of all, I've created a free masterclass. If you want to know what it takes to enter a deeper relationship than the ones you've been in, there's a 40-minute class that I created for you. You click on the first link in the description of this video, enter your name and email when you're prompted for it, and then you'll be immediately directed to watch this free class. If you want my hand-holding and help, there's a second link under the description of this video that will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a passionate life.